Alright, so right here we're a whole wheat bread. Start off another band from Florida, right?
Yeah, yep. Jacksonville, Florida, to be exact. Duval County, to be specific.
Duval!
Yeah.
You get a lot of bands coming out of there, man. Red Seats from there. We're talking earlier about Shine Down, the older 13 special.
Limp Bizkit.
Limp Bizkit.
69 yeah. Boys.
69 Boys, yep.
Holy Bread.
Man, what brought y'all to the festival? What was the draw coming to the festival? I know y'all go way back with Rick, so if y'all want to touch on that, that'd be cool.
Yeah, I mean, we met Rick a long time ago, you know, and he's always hooked us up every time we've come to town. He's always putting on the shows, and I mean, we always love to come out, and especially something like this, we'd love to come out and support doing stuff like this, you know, mm-hmm. especially seeing people come out, especially towns like this, you know, it's always an amazing thing, so.
Yeah, and plus there was a show that we were supposed to play for Rick a while back, and we had to cancel on him at the last moment, so we definitely like felt like we had to make it up to him, you know what I'm saying, and
Yeah. Come
out here and play this definitely for that, you know. Yeah, because we, like we said, we got a relationship that goes way back. Seeing him grow into this is like, wow.
Yes, we were talking to him earlier, and he was talking to y'all, and y'all like, where did all this come from?
Yeah, exactly.
That's awesome. Yeah. So far, everything we've heard, y'all probably been the bangingest band out there, blown up. Everyone's liked the sound and everything. What were your influences as far as musically coming up? The kind of... Your sound is a lot more diverse.
Yeah. Well, I mean, our sound pretty much reflects everybody in the band. We all have really different musical upbringings, you know. Like me, I'm kind of like the grunge era, you know, like Nirvana, Stone Temple Pilots, Pearl Jam, Alice in Chains, like that kind of stuff. And like as far as punk, like Guttermouth and like Pennywise and NoFX, all that kind of stuff, you know. And like, I don't know, Aaron's like completely
yeah,
different.
Yeah, well, not completely different. I mean, the grunge era, there was also other shit going on where I was listening to like Green Day and Rancid, Rage Against the Machine, as far as like shit with guitars goes, you know what I mean? But then I liked a lot of shit like Wu-Tang Clan, fucking Trick Daddy, fucking now I like 3-6 Mafia, I like T.I. a lot. But as far as rock, I mean, I wish Transplants were still around. Shit. Yeah, those are my influences.
Yeah, y'all were checking one out, like, you know, you had, like Swollen Members and Bonic Jive, any of those guys?
No, not familiar.
You gotta check those guys out then, because it's kind of hard to describe them. It's like speed rap with metal behind it, but it's, man, it's like a really fast bounce. You know, Rage has got the bounce.
Yeah.
It's like that, except it's a lot more. In your face, you know, check those guys. I was listening to some of the stuff y'all did, and I was kind of wondering, like, Swollen Members, a little more laid back, Punk Five, you know, and then, but then the Bionic has got more of the metal to it, so
Right. Definitely
check those guys out. You know, they're Scottsdale, Arizona.
Nice.
Killer. All right, so far y'all have got two albums out, right?
We got two albums and an EP.
And the EP?
Yeah.
So y'all currently working on anything new that y'all want to throw out?
Yeah, we got we got kind of three different things in a sense. We have a project that we have, Whole Wheat Bread and Murs, and that's called The Invincibles. Murs is from LA, and he's what's the name of the group that he was in?
Living Legends.
Living Legends. He's like pretty much he's all over MTV and shit, famous rapper and shit, and the we got a side project with him, and we also working on a new record now, our fourth record. And besides that, we also on Lil Jon's new record that's dropping on June 8th, coming out. We got a track on Lil Jon's record with Ice Cube and The Game and Elephant Man.
Damn.
Yeah.
So any collaborations that y'all working on, or let me put it this way, are there any bands that y'all haven't got to play with that you would like to play with that maybe outside of... out of the norm, you know?
Shit, that's outside of the norm? What, that's a good question for you.
I mean, I don't know. I mean, we've played with Rancid. I mean, that was
amazing. That's not outside the norm.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. But I mean, I don't know, bands I'd love to play with. I'd love to play a show with Green Day. That'd be fucking awesome.
Yeah.
It'd be cool playing a show with like System of a Down, band like that.
Yeah. I'd like to play a show with Avril Lavigne. I ain't gonna lie. I like to play a show with Avril Lavigne.
I'll be sick that day. I'll have diarrhea and puking at the same time.
Working at both ends there.
Yeah.
Who in the, like right now, as far as the music scene goes, who do y'all see is, a lot of guys I talk to, they say, you know, for a long time, everything's had kind of the same sound. Yeah. What do y'all see that sets yourself apart from, other than being, you know, the punk genre as is, you know, but y'all aren't just completely punk though.
Right.
So what do y'all see as being basically what sets y'all apart as far as your sound goes? Live shows, videos are cool as far as, you know, looking at almost like shorts, you know. I thought that was pretty cool.
What do you think, Joe? I got a good answer for that, but I want to see what you say first.
I think
what sets us apart is the same thing that would set apart a band like Dropkick Murphys or Flogging Molly, when you have such a strong Irish influence,
yeah,
or Celtic influence. So that's what sets them apart as far as just the normal punk rock world. So where they're as punk, so they fit into the box of punk, but they're set apart by the four-leaf clover,
yeah,
set apart by the Irish. So you have Holy Bread. What sets us apart is what we bring into it as far as what we are. They're Irish or whatever, so they bring what they got. We are Black, you know, yeah. What we bring in is kind of reggae. What we bring in is kind of rhythm. What we bring in is chanting brat kind of hip hop style. When I say holy, y'all say bread, you know, and that all kind of comes from kind of hip hop background. So it's just using what you got kind of in the same way they use it, you know what I'm saying? But that's pretty much all it is. And that, so just using what you got makes you stand out. That's my answer to that.
So would y'all say like a band, maybe like, you know, like Living Color or something like that, was like an influence y'all coming up going, wow, that's not what I would expect, you know?
I never even listened. I couldn't tell you the name of one Living Color song. Could you?
Yeah.
Cult of Personality.
Yeah, that's a big one, dog.
Yeah, that's a good album, too.
I don't even know about none of that.
Vernon Reid on guitar, man. That's insane.
Yeah, I mean, I know about the band and stuff, but I wouldn't necessarily say they like influenced me. You know what I'm saying?
I guess the question when you were saying, you know, other than being Black and in a kind of a punk scene, you know, which is not really the norm, you know, you see other bands that have like Killswitch Engage. You know, their front man's Black, and they rock, and you would never know. You know, it's. That's not really the norm to see a Black guy out there fronting.
It's just like that.
So it kind of really, you know, it gets your attention. It's like, you know, that's not the norm, but it really didn't change anything up other than, you know, it breaks a stereotype. Let me put it that way. It breaks the stereotype.
Yeah. Yeah. So, well, it's like what you see when we play on stage. It's like that shit's real, you know, and it takes people by surprise, I guess, because they're not used to seeing it, like you said. But like for us, it's like a normal everyday thing, you know. It's like what we love to do, you know. So it's like when you get up there and you can really like put your heart into something, people realize that, you know, and see that it's not just like some bullshit, you know.
Well, let me ask you, as far as the like the industry side and everything, when y'all go in to record and stuff like that, do y'all spend like a lot of time like sitting down writing the songs? Do you do a lot of writing on the road, you know, like this right here, you're on a bus and, you know, going from one place to another? Is that where you do most of your collaboration, or is it in the studio, or do y'all depend more like on your live shows to represent y'all other than what you record and put out on?
A lot of our collaborations have been done just in the studio. Actually, all of our collaborations have just been done in the studio. None of them have been on the road where we met the artists. So, I mean, we have met a lot of artists on the road, but it's funny that we've never actually collaborated with them. The ones that we have collaborated with have just been like kind of, yo, man, hey, you know, just kind of through the grapevine we meet each other. But as far as making our own stuff, I would say that the last album, definitely a lot of that was written on the road. And then the first album, a lot of that was written at home. And then this record, since we haven't been touring a lot lately, the new record, the fourth record, a lot of that has been written at home. And yeah.
All right. What about say like line of changes in the band? I know there's been like a lot of different, you know, people that have come and gone and stuff like that. Has that influenced, has that any kind of influence on y'all as far as writing music, performing, something like that? Did someone coming or going take away or add to?
Yeah, I mean, every time it happens, every new person that comes in, I mean, well, every person that goes out in the first place, I mean, you definitely like feel a loss, you know what I'm saying? So it does take something away, you know, because I mean, everybody contributes something in their own way, you know? And then when you get somebody new, you know, it's like you have to learn their style, how it's going to fit with your style, you know, and what you're doing. So it's like, yeah, it's basically like anytime we've ever had, because usually it's always been the bass player. Anytime we've ever had a new bass player, it's like we come in and it's like we basically relearn the songs, you know what I'm saying? Like with everybody, we like
bass players in trouble.
Yeah. And it's just like, I mean, everybody is individual, you know, everybody has their own style, their own flavor that they can add to the mix, you know.
I just noticed like a lot of the bands, if you know, they go through lineup changes and stuff like that, and you kind of wonder, you know, not what happened, but you know, what is that going to change as far as the band sound and stuff like that? And does that person kind of feel like, are they filling in? Are they a member of the band? So, but obviously, this festival has blown up way bigger than anyone expected, which is awesome. So, would y'all be looking forward to coming back and this become an annual event? Y'all showing up and playing?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, especially anything that's got to do with Rick. You know what I'm saying? That's my homeboy. So. You know what I'm saying, for sure. Yeah.
Awesome, man. Y'all planning on doing anything just coming back up here and playing, or y'all talking anything right now about maybe doing something here, not event-wise, but just coming up here and doing a show?
We are about to.
All right.
Yeah.
We can look forward to that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
do y'all pretty much tour just the South, or y'all full-on?
Nah, man, we all over, man. We last year we went to Scotland, England, and Wales and shit. We've been all like Canada a few times. Fucking a whole United States. Been seeing everything you can see in the United States. Fucking all that shit.
Yeah, we've pretty much been touring in the past 6 years. You know, yeah. 6-7 years. So,
any good road stories? Anything that just stands out as like just a killer story though?
I like Vegas. I want. Me and Will Frazier, our bass player, we got a system on the penny slot machines. We work between the penny slots and roulette, and usually wind up coming out on top.
Man, we got way wilder stories.
What was that, really? For real? You serious? We talking? Oh man, you crazy, man.
Oh, crazy shit. Man. I don't even want to be talking about that.
That's hilarious. Girls, you know, whatever else, man.
I mean, I played first in 12, second in 12. Later on. That's cool. It's cool, man. Man, we appreciate y'all coming out here and talking to us and stuff. And like I said, everyone we've heard is just like, dude, that was so far, that has been the killer set. So,
thanks.
Really appreciate y'all coming out here and talking to us. And look forward to seeing y'all next year and then any upcoming events that y'all are going to be doing with Rick. So,
for sure. We'll be back.
Awesome, man. Well, man, I appreciate it. Thanks a lot.